because there's this bone in the back. So you need more space in the back.
Susan, can you explain what are you doing the next step right now?
Right now, I take the muscle off the finger and then put on the other paper, transfer to the other paper, pattern. Okay, this piece is the back piece, and I only have a half a muscle. But when I transfer to the other paper, then fold the other paper, okay. Then I want to save for the dollar paper. Then I make it just enough. Fold the dollar paper here. Yeah, okay. Then put the dollar paper over here. Put the muscle in. This is the center back fold.
Then I pin it, the muscle with the dotted paper and get the pencil line. Then I'm using the tracing wheel. Thank you. Then I don't need the, I can work out the tracing paper. Okay, tracing wheel over here. Okay. Then I have the little tiny hole over here. Wait. Can I do it on the table?
Yeah.
I put one over here, and the dot, oh, and then I stop it in here. Okay. Then let me give you the princess's scene over here too. Okay. This one is a sleeveless. This is a sleeve with the sleeve. This is regular neckline over here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Whatever the style you want to do, you do later. The end of the dot. Okay. Okay, now on the dotted paper, I want to make a straight line over here. Okay, this is the princess's seam. I just keep the mark over here. Then I give the dot. The dot over here is 1 inch, the dot. Then from the princess seam, I give half inch. Then now total is 1 inch dot over here. Then, okay, this is the point over here. You put the stop it over here, then when the girl is sewing, they have to stop over here. Then I give them the mark over here, it's called the hole. Usually we're using the awl. Yeah, to put the hole over here, because at the other side we also need that too.
I don't see it in there.
I have a hole punch.
Yeah.
Can you repeat again? How do they hide it, Carl?
Okay.
For the dot?
When the pattern, we make a dot, we put the hole over here.
Mm-hmm.
Then when the cutting, the people cutting one piece or a whole bunch or whatever, then they using the jewel to make a hole on the fabric. Then this way, when the girl is sewing, they know this is the notch, this is start to sew, stop it in here, have to cover this hole, the fabric.
So they go a little bit beyond that?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Then I just tracing the mark from the muslin.
Mm-hmm.
First, yeah. And also whatever the dot you have to do it on the on the soft paper pattern,
mm-hmm,
to make it line.
So Susan, can you repeat that you say that we need to close the dot on the soft pattern, soft paper pattern?
Yes, because after we close, we do it, pin it, the dot, then we make the waistline over here.
It's curved a little.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's going. We cannot just open it and make a straight line.
Mm.
Now, okay, I'm going to give you the sleeveless line, okay, and then I put the pencil mark over here. Okay, here. Over here, I need the half inch seam for the waist.
Mm-hmm.
Half inch seam.
Seam allowance, half inch, mm-hmm, for the waist.
Yeah, over here. Okay, the side seam also we need half inch.
Mm.
Okay, and the back over here I give 1/8 bigger. It come to the data paper.
The center back?
This is the side back.
Oh, okay.
The back piece.
Side.
Yeah, now I give you half inch seam.
Okay, on the side seam.
On the side. Yeah, I give the size seam 1/8 the pencil mark, because when we put the muslin on the figure, sometimes we pull it a little bit. Okay, we have to do it on the data paper. Okay. Okay, I need this one for the waist here. Okay. Here.
Mm.
The waist is like little bit lower over here,
uh-huh,
a little bit higher over here, because we have
the curve.
We have the bone here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The hip.
The hip over the yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So we always mark the waist with the French curve.
Okay.
Okay.
Not a straight line.
Let me show it to you, the dot over there. Here. Here, let me open it.
Okay.
It's not straight.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah, a little bit. We cannot, that's why we cannot make a straight line.
Okay. And how much allowance do you do at the bottom?
Half inch similar.
Half inch.
See, when we make a dot over here,
mm-hmm,
is a little bigger, 5/8, because we need this line.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the seam allowance is a little bit larger than
it. Yeah, okay. It's make it smooth. Using, mm-hmm, this one, make it smooth.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Now I come up to the shoulder now. Okay. The front neck over here, I give them half inch. The end of the shoulder here, I give them 3/4. because the neck is not, okay, over here is more, I need more room to the front.
Okay.
So at the shoulder, we're giving...
The neck, a half inch at... And the end of a shoulder, I add 3/4.
So where the shoulder and neck meet is mm-hmm. 3. Oh, yes.
At the back piece.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Okay. Here, let me put.
Yes, that piece, that's going to be longer to go over.
See? The shoulder here is more. Here, you can see. You see? The dot is over here like this. Okay. Then you can put the pencil mark over here. Then after the awl, we'll be using the notch to cut the notch. Right now, you don't need to buy this because you can using the scissor to cut it like, cut it like this. Okay, this is for the people cutting. The cutting people cut this notch and then when go to the girl follow the notch, the front and the back to match the notch.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. I am not going to cut yet because I have to make the front part too. Mm-hmm. Until the front part I have then the front part I have to match everywhere. Okay. Match the shoulder, match the side seam, and then to make the around the neck smooth and the armhole smooth to this is the back and the armhole smooth to the front.
Okay.
And then the shoulder. Okay. I'm not cutting right now. I'm going to transfer the front part, okay?
Okay.
And the side seam is a half inch, right?
Yeah, side seam half an inch, yeah. Then this.
So can I touch your shirt? So this seam,
just now it's doing the center
back,
front.
It's the half plus 3/4. So there's
I'm going
more
to do the center
back
front
here,
one piece.
And it sits this
okay, whatever you decide later, if open the center front buttonhole or the center back zipper or the side zipper.
We could do it.
Yeah, we can do it later. I'm going to give you the slogan for the one piece of front and one piece back.
Okay.
We can follow the data. Strict grant. If you want the bias, if the fabric, you need the bias. Over here, they already have everything. Here, this is a bias. Follow this line. This is the bias for the fabric cutting. For the bonding, like this.
You cut it on the bias.
Yeah, and sometimes the dress, something like that. And they want flat, and then they cut this way because more stretch here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dripping.
This side of back, this side of front. And then that means this is the top, this is the top too.
And then this way here. Then later I can match the shoulder seam to make the armhole small. This is the center front line, they're not putting like this because of the paper.
It's easier to work with the paper.
Yeah,
I see that.
First on the muslin, on the figure, make the style.
Okay.
The five. Over here, put the mushroom, put all of the pencil mark, the red mark, whatever. Just we know what
okay.
this is. This is the princess seam over here, give to you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The princess goes in the middle of the dart.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Just to yeah, remember this. Mm-hmm. When we put the pencil, mm-hmm. just put the light. Okay, this is a sleepless. Sleepless. Okay. This is with the sleep. The neckline, I keep the pencil mark light over here. Now I'm going to make it dark on the paper. Okay, face to the side seam.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the dot, the waist dot face to the side seam. We don't use this counter thing. The bus dot, whatever you like to dripping, when you drip, you can lower a little bit, or you can from here to up there. You can from down here to up there, and from a little bit lower, it's okay. I see mine here. Okay, I keep the front part a little wider than the back. This is the finish line because of the back, I add more to the back shoulder,
mm-hmm.
to the back shoulder seam. Then the front, I'm going to take a quarter out. Take the quarter out. And then I have to add half inch seam line.
So okay. You take a quarter and you add a half.
at the half of what the seam.
Okay.
Mm. Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
So she reduced the front quarter inch.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then.
Okay.
From
then
that, based on seam allowances for half inch seam allowance.
Okay. Mm.
For the front.
Okay, now I put the front and the back, the side seam together. This way you make it better line, the waistline and the armhole line. Okay, this is the finished line here. Yeah. Put the pin on the side seam, finish line.
Like you are sewing it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sewing it, yeah. This outside line, I have an inch seam line. I'm going to cut later. But right now, I give you the waist. The waist I give you half an inch, yeah.
Okay.
Half an inch here. Yeah. Okay. Then now I'm going to do it using this. This is really good.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
French
using
coat.
This one to make the line smooth. Okay. Yeah. Okay, like this.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So that gives it the shape, the structure.
Yeah. Okay, this is the armhole right now. Okay, I can cut right now because I draw the line. Yeah, I can cut the waist right now. Now I'm going to draw the armhole, the underarm.
Mm-hmm.
Now the side seam match the front and the back. Okay. Then I draw the armhole.
Do you use the awl to punch a hole or no? Because how do you know the side? How do you know where they meet when you have that over the top like that?
Yeah, this is the finish line.
Oh, I see. Using the top one as the guide.
Yeah, then the bottom finish line, I pin it.
Okay.
Okay, this mm-hmm. is the seam, and then I do it like this. The back armhole is always have to be bigger than the front armhole.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here. Okay, using this one for the armhole.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Here. Okay.
So that they're matching.
Yeah. And then over here has to be smooth.
Straight or
is it not like triangle?
Too?
If you're doing one by one, then over here maybe triangle, but you have to do it this way, the right way.
Oh. It doesn't have to be straight.
No.
Okay.
Okay. First, let me get the top. Okay. Then the bottom. We turn around. Keep turning until the right ankle.
Okay.
Here. Okay. Then I get them. All right. I'm not cutting over here yet because I still have to match the shoulder.
Okay.
The shoulder over here, this is the front. Then the finish line is over here. Then I top off the finish line.
Mm-hmm.
if I pin the shoulder together, I can get the neckline and the armhole. The armhole smooth. Okay. See over here. Yeah, we have to make it the front and the back smooth. Otherwise, a little corner going to not too good. Okay. Okay. Now I can cut now, because I match the side seam, then match the shoulder. I
can
cut.
And you add any seam oil?
Yes, I have a quarter.
Oh, okay.
Is that any time you need to join piece together, so you add half inch, and the one only using a self-facing or finish, you use quarter inch? Most of the time? Yeah, for the neckline, you use only quarter inch of the seam allowance, right?
Yeah, for the neckline quarter, the sleeveless armhole quarter.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Now I'm cutting the side seam now.
Okay.
This is a regular neckline, really tight. If whatever you want to lower the neckline, then you from the regular, then you lower 1 inch or 2 inch. This is the front neckline here.
Okay.
Using this is to back neck, and then using this one.
Why do you use two different ones for the back and the front?
Because this one is hard to get.
Yeah, the corner.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's hard to get over here.
So you use whichever tool fits best with the
Sometimes
muslin
I'm using this for the armhole. Whatever I need to do it. Now I can cut the neckline right now. Holding here, then this way it won't move. Okay. Okay, now I want to measure the armhole now. This is the finish line. When you measure, you like this. You're measuring like this. Or you're using push pin.
What do you mean when you use a push pin? You tack it and then
To match, then it won't move. But now I'm using the hand. Yeah, okay, here. Using the fin measure, see how big the armhole. Okay, right now the back is 8 3/4. It's 8, almost 9 inch. Okay, 8 3/4. Yeah. 8 3/4, or 8 7, not even 9. Yeah, this is the finish line. It figure 9 inch.
Okay.
It figure 9 inch. Okay, the front is smaller. With the finish line of shoulder here, finish shoulder line here. Okay, over here is 8 1/4. The front is smaller. bigger than quarter. Total together, those are 17 inch sleeveless.
Mm-hmm.
The armhole. Okay. When we do the pattern, we write it down all of the measurement here.
Mm-hmm.
And after all of the measurement, then you write it down on the last page, cut the mask. The waist. This way, we write it down the measurement here when we put on the cut mask, then we know the last page.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. You can see the waist and all. Okay, the waist 7.5 inch. Okay, write it down here, 7.5. The back waist is 6.5, 6.25. Okay. Usually the over here asks you the high point shoulder. The high point shoulder is over here. This is a finish line. The high point shoulder is here. We measure. Yeah, when I open the pattern, yeah. Measure here.
To the waist?
Now it's 16 and a half. Okay, then I write it down over here. Okay, this is a high point shoulder. The waist, okay. Across shoulder, measure the back from the center back. From the center back to the end of a shoulder. I only have a quarter seam allowance, then that means I have a 15 inch across shoulder.
Okay, so cross shoulder is always made from the center backs
yeah.
to the edge to the of the
end
shoulder.
Of, to the end of the shoulder.
I see.
Yeah.
That's how you measure.
Finish it.
Thank you.
Okay. And now measure the 15. Okay. Usually like, okay. 5 inches from the high point shoulder. 4 inches. Okay, over here. Yeah, I can see you. Okay. 5 inches over here. Finish is 6.75, 13.5. Yeah. 13.5. The back, across the back, 5 inches below high point shoulder. Yeah. The across shoulder is 15. This is the back. Okay. Now I come to the front.
So for the cross shoulder width is from the highest point to the 5 inch down.
5 inch down across. Across. How many inch? It's called across the back and across the front from high point shoulder. How many inches? Make pattern. We have to write down all of the measurement because of this way, and then know the measurement. The grading company going to follow this measurement to grading up. Down.
Mm-hmm.
Now I measure the front. Now the front armhole, I need to cut off more because the front has to be smaller than the back. One armhole, I need more to cut off from here. Okay,
how do you know you need to cut it smaller? So
because The back over here, 5 inches down, I have a 13.5. 13.5 is 6¾. But right now, I have more than same thing as the back. Mm. That's why I have to take something out. Because over here, we don't need that much. Mm-hmm. If I don't take that out, and then over here going to too much stick out.
Yeah.
The back here, I need more.
Okay.
From the shoulder, then I little bit tiny doing shape. The front, across front, 5 inches below hyphen shoulder, I have a 13. The bust line right now. From the armhole, finish line 1 inch down. We measure the bust. That's how we make pattern, write it down all the measurement over here. Then after this first sample, finish sewing, then measure again, see how different. Okay, right now it's 9.75. Leave it back. The neck wood, W-I-D-T-H, the neck wood, so how wide is the neck open? And then from the center back here, from center back here to, from center back using the ruler, the finish line is a 3 inch. 3 inch half, but then it's a 6 inch open. The net width is a 6 inch. Okay. 6 inch on the shoulder, finish line here. And over here, the center front finish it. It's a 2.5. The front neck drop 2.5. This is very tight, it's a regular neckline, okay. The back neck drop, we put it on the finished shoulder seam, and okay, see how much it's dropping. Okay, finish line is 1¼. And if you have a skirt, then you put the center front, not the back, you put too much. The neck, because you need the collar to match, then you need the notch. This way they match for the skirt.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Center front.
The center front make one notch. Okay. The armhole we make give them know this is the front. Okay. Let them have a one notch. The back, we have a 2. Okay. Then this way we know this piece at the back, this piece is the front. Okay. But if you have a slip, then the slip have to match the notch. Okay. Okay. Then you go look at that.